I think technology provides a real opportunity to assess students in more efficient ways and to provide real-time data back to students and teachers. We know that good assessment is integral to good instruction, and it should be just part of how teaching and learning happens. And so when teachers can use technology to quickly assess and check student progress, they can get right back into instruction. And so it's a seamless transition between teaching, students demonstrating, practicing, and then assessing, and then right back into the cycle.
For many years, technology was really used in a summative assessment way, kind of almost a standardized test online, a paper pencil test online, and it wasn't that much different. But what we've seen over the last decade has been a movement into unique ways to do formative assessment. And technology can play an integral role in teachers being able to get those in-the-moment checkpoints during the process of learning, which is what formative assessment is. So there's a lot of software now that allows students to be working on maybe a mathematics problem, and the teacher can actually log in at the same time synchronously and see what they're doing and give them feedback in the moment about what they're doing.
The biggest thing has been feedback. Technology has made that so much easier for me, but for the kids, they can be so much more responsive. You know, I can give feedback, they get an email or a comment right away, and they're eager to check, and then they're eager to fix. And so that process for feedback especially, I feel, has been really streamlined.
So you can see who's really getting it, and you can see who's maybe struggling with how to get started. Mm-hmm. And it allows you to make comments as they're working.
I think it makes too flexible grouping mm-hmm. so much easier because we don't have to wait. You know, normally they do an assignment, it's due Friday, and then we're moving on. Here, it's like, do we do it Monday? Tuesday, I can check and I know what these kids need. I can sort them, I can group them way easier. Mm-hmm. Just makes that process so much more simple, and then we're able to reach kids way faster.
The impact on technology on student learning is difficult to measure. It's challenging to measure. We are using some software across the entire state of Iowa.
One of the things that Iowa actually, a product that Iowa brought in, teachers fill out a survey, and so, you know, it is self-rating to say how technology is being used. Students fill out a survey to talk about how technology is being used, and that compiles information across those different surveys to show how the technology is being used, you know, about how, what access do teachers have to technology or do students have to technology at home, as well as what's being done with that technology and what skills that teaching staff might have to use that technology.
And so one of the things that we've done is to implement something called Brightbites. And Brightbites is just a data source that we take a survey with parents, students, and teachers, grades 3 through 12, and try to get areas that we're doing well with.
With Brightbites, we're able to see how kids are using technology and if it's making an impact on the learning that they have.
One of the things that we've done to take the Brightbites data even further is to create a 4C team, a leadership team with technology. The 4Cs stand for communication, creativity, critical thinking, and collaboration. We look at that data and then we try to help teachers within the 4C areas get that to their students. And then every year we measure our data, did we improve in those areas?
With the other teachers.
We, as a committee, had a set time where all of the teachers got together to do the Brightbites survey. We get the results back and we look through and we kind of just look at what are some areas that are a high need for teachers that they're really seeming not to use technology or not understand how to do it.
And this is one of the few ways that we've been able to say, besides just we know it's making a difference, come watch our classrooms. We have some data that we can show the school board, we can show our community, and we're very, very proud of the direction we're going with that.
Once we identify the need is there, we can then create measures that help us project the kinds of things that we need to do in order to enable kids and teachers to be working around those 4Cs, and we're starting now to actually see improvement in those areas. So that's very exciting.